Hey, what's up, guys? Weekly Light here, and today I'm going to be bringing you another team composition guide in Pit People. So today's team is going to be based entirely off of AoE, which I think means area of effect, but basically it's big booms. So this team is all about big explosions over big areas and dealing a lot of damage really quickly. So this will make your games go by really quickly. So first off is the Rainbow Horse. So I made this my hero because of how much damage it does, so it gets a big damage buff when it becomes the hero, and this is probably my main DPS. So when the horns do work, they will explode and deal massive damage to the tile it lands on, plus the six surrounding hexagons that touch it. And so I also like to pair this with a mascot because the mascot will buff its accuracy, so it's more likely to hit on target, and it might also deal more damage. I'm not really sure how the mascots work, in all honesty. And then next up is the mascot, of course. So it buffs the Rainbow Horse, and it also buffs my other troops. But mainly, the main thing I want is the accuracy increase, so it consistently hits big groups. It also can be it explodes for large damage in the surrounding tiles. It deals about 50 damage to all those tiles, so that's really good. So it usually takes out a fair chunk of any enemy, and it will definitely one-shot kobolds, zombies, and gnomes. But the main thing is, it can pretty much two-hit anything else or get them down to like a quarter of their health. So I like to use the gnomes and launch them when their health is low into the enemy lines. So then next up are the gnomes. So the gnomes are for launching the mushrooms and the mascots, because the mushrooms and mascots are good in the front lines because of the big explosion and also the toxic cloud that the mushroom can create. But the mushroom has really low movement speed, which is why you need the gnomes to launch them into the front lines. Gnomes are also good against robots, which is a big weakness of my team because my team's pretty much weak to robots, so the gnomes are the only things to stop them from steamrolling. So next up is the mushroom. So the mushroom provides poison damage to all the tiles around it, and it's very good once it's in the front lines. And even if your enemy's spread out a little bit, if there's only one tile between their troops, you can still hit two for one with the mushroom. So that's also very good. Sadly, it's not very good against robots or large swarms of robots because it'll do a single target headbutt against robots, which does a lot of damage, but it sadly can't hit two robots at the same time, which is the downside. And then last up is the Pixie, which doesn't really synergize well with any of the rest of my team, except for the fact that it also deals large amounts of AoE damage, and it deals fire damage, which is very important for countering those hair trolls and those troll moms. So those are very common in the PvP pit, so I like to run it just to counter those hair trolls and take them out real easy. And then the last slot, I picked a Wraith, but this is sort of the optional slot, so you can put whatever you want here. I just want to try out the Wraith. This is where you'd put your recruiter if you're going out in the wild to recruit stuff with this team, or this is where you put your favorite character if you wanted to. So that's what all the things do. And okay, so now let's get to the pros and cons of this team. So I'll start with the pros. So it does have a wide variety of damage types. So it does poison, fire, and rainbow damage, along with the gnome like wrench damage, which is good on robots only. And the fire damage and the poison damage pretty much cover most of the other stuff in the game. And then the Rainbow Horse's horns hit pretty much everything hard, but it hits Wraiths especially hard. So I think there's nothing in the game that really resists every single thing in my team. So that's good. Another good thing about the team is that it's really good on enemies that like to group up, or enemies like the troll mom that are inherently big. Because a lot of my troops will hit large areas, large targets are really weak against this, especially if they have like multiple targets, like a perfectly like aimed Rainbow Horse shot plus a pixie in one turn can wipe out both of the kobolds or both of the mascots or not mascots, both of the gnomes or both the zombies real easily, so that's always good. And also, if you're lucky, you can take out multiple of the troll mom minions in one turn, or you could just deal massive damage to just regular humans and whatnot just around the field. Basically, it's not a good idea to group up against this team. And another great thing about this team is how fast the games go. Because of the kamikaze-like nature of my team, where I'm just flinging my troops at them, games usually don't last more than 17, 18 turns. Usually will end maybe like 10 to 15 turns most of the time, just because either they destroy me when I just bum rush them, or I destroy them when they bum rush me. Okay, so now let's get to the cons or the downsides. So I realized that robot swarms sort of destroy my team, because the robot swarms, my two gnomes can't really kill more than three robots. So if there's four robots, I sort of get overwhelmed and they just destroy my pixie early game, and my pixie's a lot of my DPS. So that's a problem. And then also there's a little bit too much AoE, which could be bad if you're recruiting and, like, let's just say you're trying to capture that cupcake in the back, right? But you accidentally keep hitting it with like big explosions, and then it dies second to last instead of being the last thing alive. So that's pretty bad. Another thing is, it's very, the Rainbow Horse especially, it's very inaccurate. So I was at this one game where I had the 2-on-1 advantage, and all I really needed to do was land one Rainbow Horse shot, which would do enough damage to kill the enemy. But my Rainbow Horse kept missing shots, and in the end, the enemy won a 1-on-2, so that was pretty sad. Like, it kept missing shots over and over. So it's not the most consistent thing if you don't have a mascot nearby. And so that's another bad thing. And the final bad thing is, it's weak against teams that like to spread out. So usually teams are built around sticking together. So I'd say 80% of the time you don't have a problem. But on the rare case you have stuff that likes to spread out, like having a couple, like an archer, a rainbow horse, and vampire. Let's see what else likes to hang out. Ranged units like the Wraith. Stuff that they don't have to stick together, and they can sort of just hit you from all angles. My team's not very good against that, because my team is meant to deal damage to big groups. And efficiency goes down if you can't hit two targets in one turn with one attack. Okay, so now let's get to viability in the different areas. So the unfair challenge, this is not a good team for unfair challenge. The way the team works, or how I like to play with it, you can modify it, but the way I play it is, I like fast games, so I just bum rush them. So it's not good for lasting three rounds. You can modify the team and give it some more sustain, and it might last three rounds, but it's not engineered for that. It's really meant for PvP, because in PvP you want a fast-paced game, like let's just say you know you're going to have to eat soon or something like that, or you have to go or something. You can just mow down an enemy just really quickly. And then for the wild, I'd say it's not very good for recruiting, just because, like I said earlier, the AoE could kill your target accidentally, so that could be bad. Okay, so I'm going to wrap up this video, and I just have to say, if you have any team suggestions, put them in the comments. If you have any myths or whatnot you want me to test, I can test them for you. If you have any feedback, like let's just say you hate my voice, you can comment on that too. I will not take offense. And so thank you for watching, and catch you next time.